So we have this HP Mini 110, little netbook, and I was planning on letting my wife use it when she's out and about town, and, you know, she has an upcoming trip coming up. However, she's using it the other day, and instead of, you know, the space where you put in your password, it just starts filling up the space with commas. And she went to browse, type in something, and it just started repeatedly doing the comma. And, you know, you check the keyboard, everything's fine. Next thing I did was I downloaded every possible update. Well, it had a 16 gigabyte solid state hard drive, and I kid you not, with Windows 7 Home Premium and all the updates, it was using 15 out of 16 gigabytes on the hard drive. So it wasn't a very practical situation. So, two things. Replaced the hard drive, and keyboard was still doing the commas, so replaced the keyboard. I'm going to show you how to replace the keyboard on a netbook. Now, the thing is, with the HP Mini, the keyboard is sort of anchored. There's three different anchors, and the third one's a bit of a bitch. So, let me show you what I have here. Here's the Mini. I taped some of the screws I've removed, because I don't want to lose them. Now, here's the keyboard. What you have to do, once you release the anchors that I'll show you, is actually pry this up. You pry it up in the middle here, you get it up on the sides here, and there's no other way. I watched an instructional video, and that's the way it was done. On the back, where the battery is, I'm going to remove the battery, if I can do this with one hand, and show you what I'm talking about here, as far as the areas where the screws are. Let me get a light on for this. There. Okay. See the two screw areas there? There's one, two. You might think you were done. I mean, the keyboard has these things that come through, and so this metal part here is actually the bottom of the keyboard coming through, and it's screwed in. However, if you look way down in there, ha-ha, a third one. You'd have a bitch of a time if you didn't know that was there and you tried to remove the keyboard. Well, I've seen a YouTube video where somebody apparently has a similar problem with the same exact model, and their problem was the tab key was stuck and it kept repeating. So imagine how much more trouble you'd have if the tab key kept on repeating. So what I have is a new replacement. Instead of black, this one's opalescent, an opalescent keyboard. Here we go. I've loosened the screws. Should I say loosened? That's not accurate. I've removed the screws. What I've loosened is the keyboard. Let me show you that. So, with those screws removed, we're just going to pry this up. And it can fold forward like that. Here's the hard drive. What I did was I replaced the 16 gigabyte solid state drive. That's a whole story there. Let me tell you what pissed me off about that. They had it mounted to a caddy, except it was one of those teeny little, you know, mini SATA things, and not only do they have four screws in it, they were four screws that were riveted. You could not remove it. They were, you know, those seams at the other side of the screw where you just keep on turning and turning the screw, but it doesn't come out because on the other side it's fucking rivet. I didn't want to get too forceful and try to pry it out, so I used a thin drill bit and I tried to drill through the screws. One of them I got accurately, the other three I sort of went off the mark because I wasn't expecting to do that kind of operation, just to take out a hard drive. And twice I went through the actual, card. One right near where the screw connects, which I think is fine, and one slightly, I'm not sure. I haven't tried that drive. So, what I have in here, though, is a 750 gigabyte hard drive. It's a regular 2.5-inch notebook drive, and I got this for $10 because it didn't pass its smart test. It is no longer a smart test passing drive. So, some systems, like I had a Compaq NC6515B that I tried to put this in, and a message would come up, hard drive didn't pass smart test, you know, press F1 to continue. And instead of continuing, it would take me into BIOS, and I'd try to get out of BIOS, and I'd get that message again. So, never went into the operating system. With this particular BIOS, I get the hard drive didn't pass smart test, press F1 to continue, and it actually continues into the operating system. So that's good. I'm able to use it with this. And sometimes you can go for quite a long time with that, you know, dummy alarm of the smart test before anything's going to happen to the hard drive. And you know, for our purposes here, that suits it pretty well. There's a ribbon cable. And if you look back in here, all that you need to do, see this area right here, a little black strip? If you just pop this back, you can do it with one finger. I'm going to show you how easy it is. Pop it back. Here we go. And the ribbon comes out. We're going to replace it and reverse the process, and I'll show you a nice HP Mini with a 750 gigabyte hard drive. You don't find many little netbooks with that kind of hard drive. A couple gigs of RAM and a nice new opalescent keyboard to go with this black and a special hard shell case. I got it for a couple bucks. Here it is on preliminary test, just to start up Windows and to type in the letters of the alphabet and, you know, numbers to make sure everything's there. And, you know, frankly, I'm curious to see how the comma thing prints. Then we'll do the proper screw-in installation. And there it is, all installed. Tested fine, lines up real well, brought back this little netbook.